Hello, class. My name is Mariah Martin, and the activity that I used for my therapeutic play activity is an activity called I Am. I actually did this activity when I was in high school, and the fact that I still remember it means it made a very significant impact on me. It really helped boost my self-confidence and really helped me when I was in high school, when I was self-conscious or even nervous about what others thought about me. So, a little bit of background on the child that I've worked with. I had the opportunity to do this activity with my younger sister. She is 14 years old and she is a freshman in high school. She actually started high school at the start of COVID-19, which was really difficult for her because not only was COVID-19 just a distant time, and it still is, I mean, she had to adjust. Not only to the new high school that she was at and the whole new routine, but she was doing it from a distance and she wasn't able to meet as many friends as one normally would when you start high school. She is a very outgoing, fun, and positive girl. One of the biggest struggles was that my family recently moved from Kansas City to Utah. And for starters, just moving to a new place definitely is stressful. My family had always wanted to move to Utah. I mean, I'm here going to college, and they just love the mountains here and the environment. But for Lily, it's been a bit difficult. This year, she has definitely become more self-conscious. She has developed anxiety, and she is a little bit more worried about what others think about her. So the I Am activity is basically a magazine or newspaper collage geared towards adolescents. In the center, you can put I Am. The adolescent can put a picture of themselves or really anything that represents who they are in the center. They can even put their name if they'd like to. In this example, this is the one my sister created. She put I Am in the center, and in this activity, the participants can flip through a variety of magazines, cardstock. It's good to provide a bunch of resources to provide the opportunity to explore to find words, pictures, or even quotes that surround their center as basically who they are as a person. So in this one, my sister chose things that she liked, words that she felt represented her, fun pictures and backgrounds. And she really just got really creative with it, and I let her take the lead. I felt it was really important for her to take charge of this. I actually ended up doing this activity alongside of her, so she felt accompanied. So she felt like she was doing something fun along with her sister. It was kind of a memory-making activity for me with her, but also a way for her to cope with her feelings and express her feelings. And we were able to do this as we did this activity. I created this activity so that my sister could be provided with something that she could create, that she could keep for years to come, and something that would also foster her personal identity as well as her self-esteem. In the stage of identity versus role confusion, Erickson emphasizes that it is critical that adolescents develop a sense of self. The developmental stage plays an essential role in establishing a sense of personal identity, which honestly will continue to influence my sister Lily's behavior and her development throughout her life. It is so important to achieve this identity so they can stay true to themselves as well as be happy and positive. I felt like this activity would be a great way for my sister to express her emotions. It would facilitate positive conversations as a way for her to cope with her feelings and stressors that she has been experiencing. So the outcome of the activity actually turned out way better than I even expected. Initially, I figured my sister and I would only work on this for maybe like 30 minutes, listen to some fun music while we do our I Am projects, our collages. But it actually turned out to last even longer. We did this for about an hour, maybe a little more, and we talked the entire time. We talked about what we were going to put on our collage, cool things we saw in the magazines, and we talked about what we enjoy, how we feel people see ourselves through the words that we were able to find. We found a lot of really positive words that my sister picked out, and this reminded her of how unique she is as a person. This is an opportunity that we had to spend time together, and it also encouraged positive conversations about school, plans for the collage, and even the emotions she had been feeling. And I was able to acknowledge these feelings throughout this activity, which was able to help her cope with the stress that she has been experiencing. My sister made this really unique to her. The picture on a previous slide is actually the collage that she was able to make. I consider my sister a really creative and artistic person, and she really enjoyed doing this activity. She ended up actually loving it so much that we actually went and got it laminated, and she expressed to me that she had a great time and that she actually would like to do more activities like this weekly because it made her feel really good about herself and reminded her that she's her and that she doesn't care what people think of her and that friends will come, and this is a really difficult time, but things will get better. And she actually said to me, when I'm feeling down, I will remember to take a look at this collage to help bring myself back up. And I found this I am activity very rewarding. I had great discussions with my sister. She had been experiencing so many crazy roller coaster emotions, lots of stress, and it was a great distraction from all of that. She was able to create a tangible creation that she'll be able to keep with her for years to come, and it will be able to help her when she needs a little lift. This really, I felt, was a great activity in which she was able to foster her sense of identity, encourage that development of a sense of self. And she made this collage all on her own. She did this independently, and she took charge of it, which also definitely fosters this stage of development. And would I implement this activity again? I so would. I really enjoyed it, and I feel my sister also really enjoyed it. This was an activity that definitely takes a little bit of time, but if someone really enjoys art, or collages or scrapbooking, it is definitely something for them. I honestly don't know who wouldn't enjoy it. There are so many fun and interesting pictures and words that you can find in magazines. And it's amazing the words that you can find that you feel represent yourself. And I can imagine this being an activity that I would implement again.